What is good, NIO family? It's Rey-Jay back with another video. And this one, I want to break down what's going on with NIO stock, what you should be watching for moving forward. I'm also going to talk about the overall market, what's going on with SPY, Tesla, the QQQ, and NVIDIA, and just a couple of other stocks. And break down why it is possible for the market to get a small bounce just temporarily for the first couple of days of this week, and how this could affect NIO, and why it's going to also be dependent on external pieces of news. Before I break anything down with all this information, let me just mention a couple of things. I'm firstly not a financial planner, so take none of this as financial advice. And also, if you guys can, please smash the like button if you want to see more videos like this. It not only benefits me, it benefits the entire NIO community as a whole. And finally, don't forget about the Moomoo link. The offer ends very soon. If you deposit $100 into the account, you're guaranteed 5 free stocks plus a $50 cash reward. Anyways, now let's talk about NIO. How on earth is this thing looking? NIO is down 7.22% for the day on Friday after all the big news about Evergrande filing for bankruptcy, which is still bearish and very, very bearish news. Now for tomorrow, the same thing is going to likely be a big factor that could affect it depending on if NIO is part of the bounce for the market or not. But there is a chance that NIO could try to get a bounce as this thing is very, very oversold. Now, I just want to mention that, like I told you guys in my earlier videos, the fundamentals for NIO are relatively strong. Things are still strong for NIO, and it's still a very, very strong company. Okay, just a few weeks ago, people were talking about NIO going to $100. It was pumping so much, strong deliveries and such. Everything just shifted because the whole market started dropping as soon as August started with all the bank downgrades. And then we have this negative news in China. This is not NIO's fault. I just want to make that as clear as possible. But now let's break down the market. How are things looking going into this week? What should you be watching for? So on SPX, I mean, we have this possible left shoulder and a head that formed, and we're currently sitting at support on SPX. Could this drop a little bit more and then get a bounce, or is it going to like try to bounce from here? Looking at the inverse head and shoulders pattern on the very micro time frames as well, like the 1 minute or the 5 minute, you can see there's a chance we might get a bounce and form like a right shoulder. So there's a chance the market could try, especially thanks to NVIDIA's earnings. Now, what do I mean by that? Well, on Wednesday, right, we have NVIDIA's earnings coming out, and we know this thing gets lots of attention from retail. There's a chance that the buyers could step in, and we could see a lot of retail push the share price up. We could also possibly see Aapl help out with the pumping, as Aapl is very, very oversold, and Aapl's trying to get a bounce too. Let me just show you Aapl stock just to give you guys a good understanding of this. On the 4 hour time frame, if you look at the RSI, this thing was actually at about 25 at one point, very, very oversold. We also formed a bullish divergence on the 4 hour RSI and also on the MACD. So it is due for a small bounce. Looks like Aapl's going to try to bounce a little bit more. And on the daily chart, if you look at the RSI, it's at 29, very, very oversold. When did we see it this low? Well, it's been a very long time. We rarely ever see it that low, and it just like last. Typically, when it comes this low, we see a small bounce. So I do think there's a potential for a small bounce on Aapl. Either it bounces here or drops to about 160 and then bounces. I think it's going to try to bounce here. And then I'm not saying it's going to keep going, you know, forever and go all the way up to like 300 or 200 or anything like that. I'm simply saying there could be a small bounce back to about 180 or so before a possible rejection, which could help you to form this like right shoulder on SPX. But a temporary bounce is all I'm calling for in the markets. And NVIDIA, which looks quite bullish, could also do the same thing. It could be contributing to this. I think NVIDIA is getting ready for it as well. Now for data, there's nothing really coming up for tomorrow. There's going to be more stuff coming for Tuesdays. We have some Fed speakers, so I will talk more about that later on. But for tomorrow, there's not much to worry about. No crazy data, so I'm going to worry more about that later on. For the fear and greed index, we're just about to get fearful. Could this be the time they try to get the market to balance just a little bit, just to trick investors? Because everyone's talking about the crash that's coming. The market's going to crash. Maybe they give us a temporary bounce thanks to NVIDIA and Aapl, and then we see the market reverse after that. That's a real possibility. Now, looking at NIO, there was some news that came out. There are other investors coming out and analysts that are saying that NIO's fair value is $8.22. It's funny because there were no articles saying this like a few weeks ago when NIO was pumping and there was talking about bullish price targets on NIO's strong deliveries. Now, all of a sudden, as NIO drops a little bit, everyone is saying, or all these analysts are coming out and saying that based off its free cash flow, $8 is where it's going. That's the fair value. It suddenly shifted as sentiment is changing because a lot of shorts could have been piling in and they're just like trying to get NIO down, scare lots of investors. Things like this happen all the time. Deutsche Bank is saying buy NIO shares. There's a big difference there. The price price ratio is dropping, so it means NIO has lost lots of relative strength. And finally, when it comes to significant data, we saw the short interest go up to about 55.44 million NIO shares shorted. So we saw a little bit more NIO shares shorted than before. And the overall volume, it's very important to look at this, is 68 million, so a little bit less volume. It dropped on lower volume, so it wasn't that aggressive in terms of selling. But remember, the external factors like Evergrande and any news involving China could affect this. So how does NIO look? In my opinion, this thing looks like, even though we do technically have this like bullish divergence developing on it, I think it's going to get ready for a bounce soon, but I don't know if it's ready yet. That's the thing. I don't know if it's ready yet. It looked very bearish from Friday. It formed a bullish divergence, so there's a chance it's going to try to make its way up to 11 plus, but there's also the possibility of it kind of like breaking the low and coming down to about 10 points. This is like 10.2 before we get some kind of bounce. So I either see it dropping a little bit more to 10.2 and then getting a really nice bounce, or it tries to bounce a little bit from here to get back to 11. It's got to be one of those two. The market is going to likely try to bounce, so there's a good chance that this bullish divergence could play out. If NIO gets above 10.8, there's a good chance it's going to get a very, very decent sized bounce to get back to the 11s. If not, you know, there could be more downside. I'm going to break this down in more details in just a second. But like I showed you on SPX, on SPY, we have a nice inverse head and shoulders that formed on the smaller time frame. So maybe like the 5 minute shows it very nicely. You could see we formed a very, very beautiful looking inverse head and shoulders like structure. So I think the market could try to bounce thanks to NVIDIA and Apple. I just showed you guys Apple as well. NVIDIA could also try to bounce. It has a very, very nice looking divergence that formed, and this thing is getting set for it. For Tesla, it formed a bullish divergence. I could see it get back to at least 221 for a temporary bounce. You could see it's curling and forming another inverse head and shoulders like structure right here, trying to start pushing up. There's a chance the whole market could bounce quite a bit. Same thing with the QQQ, nice inverse head and shoulders. We could see this thing push up for 360 once again. But for NIO, what about NIO? Is NIO going to bounce? Well, the thing about NIO is it's looking relatively weak. Even in the after hours, it was flat. I'm thinking that it either bounces here. It depends on if we get the bounce in the morning or not. But if it does try to get above our 50 EMA, if it gets above like, you know, 10.8, we could see it try to make its way back up to 11. But it might not be ready yet. It could drop a little bit lower. So like 10.2 could come before the bounce based off the structure. So like right here, 10.2 is where we had a tendency of basing on the 4 hour time frame. So two possibilities. We either drop a little bit more and then we get a bounce on NIO back to the 11s, or it tries to bounce right here after forming this bullish divergence and we get back to 11.5. It's got to be one of those two. I'm not 100% sure because it depends on the news involving China, but a bounce should be coming relatively soon looking at the bullish divergence and the current structure of the stock. So either it drops another 40 cents to like 10.2 and then we get a bounce back to 11.5, or it just bounces from here with the whole market, thanks to NVIDIA and Apple and these different stocks out there. All right, so that's what I'm predicting for NIO. It's got to be one of those two, depending on the news. So don't forget to pay attention to that with Evergrande and everything going on. But I do believe a bounce is coming soon, and I want everyone to be prepared for that for NIO stock. All right, so thank you all so much for listening. Hopefully this was helpful for tomorrow. Remain calm, cool, and collected, and I'll see you guys in the next one. NIO to the moon, because the long term is still incredibly bright, and peace out.